Hey YouTube, welcome back to a brand new Animal Crossing New Horizons video. Today we have a very exciting one as the latest summer update Wave 2 trailer was just released. So without further ado, let's get straight into today's video. So Nintendo just released the Summer Update Wave 2 trailer, showing off all the new content that will be added to New Horizons in August. It's pretty awesome and quite a lot of new things were shown, which is super exciting. Some of the features are pretty obvious and explained in detail during the video, whilst others may have been overlooked. So today will just be a kind of an overview of everything that's coming in the next update, but I'll definitely be uploading the usual trailer analysis and breakdowns of each of the new features as the week goes on. So, the trailer kicks off with the Fireworks Festival that will happen every Sunday evening throughout the month of August, which is pretty much what we guess in our predictions, so that's really cool. As you can see, Isabelle finally ventures out of her office like the good old days and joins in the festivities on the plaza. You may also notice she's wearing a new Head Bopper too, but more on those later. You'll be pleased to know Red must now be in Tom Nook's good graces because again, just like the good old days, Red is here with Red's raffle on the plaza and appears to have a bunch of prizes either available to win or to buy. You can see all kinds of items displayed there at the back of his little pop-up store. It seems we'll have access to a whole bunch of interactive accessories such as party streamers and even bubbles, which is super adorable. Moving on, but still celebrating during the Fireworks Festival, it looks like sparklers are returning too and we'll be able to play around with those. We get a good look at the Head Boppers too that we mentioned earlier. These were a popular choice of headwear back in New Leaf, but I have to say they look so much cooler in New Horizons. Obviously there are multiple designs. We have the stars that Isabelle was actually wearing on the plaza, as well as some normal ones here on the ride. So it looks like this update will be adding a whole bunch of new accessories, which is perfect for the Fireworks Festival. Moving on, the trailer shows some of the fireworks in a bit more detail as they go off in the night sky over our island. As you can see, we'll actually be able to set certain patterns to our fireworks display if we want to, using custom designs. This was something that we could do in New Leaf, but again, I think you'll agree, the patterns and the fireworks look so much better here in New Horizons. Another thing you'll probably have already spotted in this scene is the classic villager is holding a balloon. So yet another example of an interactive item or an accessory that we can hold, which is really awesome. No doubt there will be several colors available too, so I'm sure we'll all be getting so many cool screenshots over the next couple of weeks. Furthermore, you'll be pleased to know the Firework Festivals will be every Sunday in August in both hemispheres, which is great news, so the Southern Hemisphere definitely won't be missing out on the fireworks. And that's about it for the fireworks side of things. Moving on to the second half of the trailer, we get to see the Dream Suite feature that has been rumoured for the last few weeks. Those of you who have fully developed islands will be glad to know a new building hasn't been added, but I know there will also be people who, like me, would have loved a new building to build. Anyway, to access the Dream Suite, we can use any bed it seems to fall asleep and meet Luna in an absolutely stunning dreamy land. It looks amazing. You'll probably already have spotted the adorable little gyroid steamer item too that Luna also had back in New Leaf. Anyway, once in the Dreamland, it looks like we'll be presented with options to either visit other Dream Islands or upload a dream of our own island, so it appears to work in exactly the same way as it did in the past. The idea of this is to check out other people's islands without them being online and without the risk of ruining someone's real life island. So once there, it will be much the same as visiting an actual island, but you wouldn't have any effect on it, if that makes sense. Again, another cool feature it seems is you'll have access to people's custom designs when you visit by using the design portal, which is now weirdly located at the Resident Services Plaza. I just hope this doesn't mean we can't go inside buildings, because that would be weird, but then again, maybe just the shops are closed, like the Able Sisters, and we'll still be able to go inside people's houses. We'll have to wait and see. Anyway, this feature is almost certainly replacing Wendell from New Leaf, who was the go-to character for copying other people's designs, which is a shame. I would love to have seen him return too. Anyway, finally they bring the trailer to a close by finally adding the island backup restoration service they mentioned way before the game was launched, and this will launch on July the 30th, which is the same time the update goes live. This will essentially save our island's data in case our Switch breaks or gets lost or stolen, or the save file becomes corrupt and things like that, so it's really good news. All we know right now is, much like the cloud backups, you'll need to be a Nintendo Switch Online member, but I'm sure more details about this service will follow soon. And the last thing they mentioned is the next update that will be available sometime in the fall, highlighting Jack, the Halloween special character. So without a doubt, this update will of course add their Halloween event and bring Jack back to Animal Crossing. So there we have it, that's pretty much everything shown in the latest Summer Update Wave 2 trailer. Of course, this is just an overview going over all the new features and highlighting some of the smaller details you may have missed, like the balloon and Luna's little gyroid item. I will probably upload my usual trailer analysis tomorrow and start breaking down all the new features in a lot more detail with things like how they work and what we can expect in videos later this week. But what do you think about this update? Are you happy with the pace of their updates and seeing things like the Fireworks Festival added, or were you hoping for more? Let us know your thoughts in the comments. Anyway, for now, that pretty much wraps up this video. If you're an Animal Crossing fan, don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss out on any New Horizons news. Until then, I'd like to give a special thank you to this channel's Patreon supporters, as well as this channel's members. You guys absolutely rock and truly help me upload as regularly as I do. I couldn't do it without you. Don't forget to head over to our Discord server too, and of course, if you got this far in the video, please comment Red's Raffle. Just let me know you did, that would be super awesome. And please be sure to include if you're happy they decided not to add a building for the Dream Suite. I'd love to know. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video and found it entertaining. Please be sure to leave a like if you did. Thanks for watching. I hope you have an amazing day. Stay safe, and I'll see you in my next video. Peace.